are going to review some APA formatting guidelines. So we've spent a little time on APA when you were working on essay number two, and now you're going to do more of this kind of formatting on your own. So last time I really guided you, we spent one class period formatting your cover pages and your reference pages. So now you're going to be in charge of formatting your reference pages for essay number three. So I wanted to give you some guidelines. I also want to let you know that I understand that learning about APA formatting is not the most exciting information that you could learn. So I recommend that you be patient, try to sit through this video, and in order for this activity to work, I think the best way to do it is for you to have your source material that you're going to include for essay number three, have it out in front of you. So if you found information from the databases, bring that article up. If you found an article on a website, bring up that article or web page, whatever you're using, and pause this video. I'll recommend it. Come back to it when you have your sources up and you're in front of a computer and can type out your reference page as I give you certain pieces of information so you can format it as you follow along on the video. So, what you need to do is bring up Word. So go to Word, or at the last page of your essay on a new document, you can start typing out your reference page, or if you're using the online version of Word, bring that up, and just have a clean document page in front of you. I'm going to put this aside for now, and I'm going to ask that you go to the Owl at Purdue website. I have the link on Canvas. So if you go to the link, you should be on this page. If you Google OWL, like the animal, OWL, at Purdue, then you will be taken to the website that you need, but you'll have to dig and find the APA style link. So make sure that you're on this page that has this note that says that you're working with APA 7th edition. And then on here on the left-hand side on the navigation bar, you'll notice that it says APA Style 7th edition. Then you'll have to click on here on this link that says APA Formatting and Style Guide 7th edition. And in this video, we're basically just going to review how to format your reference page. We've already done cover pages in class. I'll go over certain pieces of information later in the video, but I'm not going to spend much time with that because we spent quite a bit of time with that in class. So if you need a refresher, just look at your essay number two and format your cover page using the information that you learned back then. Okay, so for this video, what you'll need to be looking at is the reference list. So here, these different links show you how to format your references, and it tells you, if you're trying to format ebook or other kind of print sources, but for our purposes, we're going to go to electronic sources because most of you looked at online sources to find research for essay number three, the ISAE essay. So we'll click on that one, reference list electronic sources, and this page briefly talks about how to organize, format your sources on your reference page if they're electronic sources. And basically you're going to follow this format. So this is the general format that you're going to follow. You're going to find the articles, your sources, whether it has an author's name, and then when you find that piece of information, then this is the way you would format. You would have their last name, comma, and then their initial of their first name, and then the initial of their middle name, if that's listed. In parentheses, you would have the year that the source was posted online, or the year that it was published, and then the month, the date. In parentheses, your period, then the title of the web page, or the title of the article, period, and notice that it's italicized, and then you have the website name, or the journal article, whatever site is putting this out there, period, and then your URL. So in this example, what this is showing me is that this author looked at a web page named Laziness Does Not Exist. It was on this Medium website, and the person that put it out there was D. Price. And then this would be the URL for that particular source. You also have different kinds of sources. So some of your sources don't have authors. Some of them have a group that put this out there. So if that is your case for your source, then you would use this as an example. Or some of you don't have sources that have a group or an author that takes credit for putting it out there. So you just have the web page, the title of the web page to work with, or just the title of an article. So that's what you would have to start off your entry. Make sure it's italicized. Then you have the year, the month, the date. So usually that's the two that go together. The author's last name and the year, or the title of the source and the year. Those two will always be together. And then the site name, and then when you retrieved that particular source, and then the year, the date, the year, and then what the URL is. So this tells me that this person is working with this page, Tuscan White Bean Pasta. It was posted February 25th, 2018. It's on this Budget Bites website, and then the retrieval date. I would say for the most part, you're either working with this type of source that has an author, or this source that you just have the title of the web page. I know that some of you have sources that have two authors, so you would have to look up how to cite that, use this as a source. You just go through the list and try to figure out which one of these matches the source that you're using. A lot of you are also using the databases, so that means that you're looking at periodicals. So the sources from the library databases are considered periodicals. So use these examples here. This one has a DOI, which means this is a piece of information that the libraries use to organize their sources. So it stands for Digital Object Finder. So if you do have that information, when you click on that journal article or that periodical, then offer that. But if you're using like the CQ Researcher from the library databases, those don't have DOIs. So I'd say for the most part, a lot of yours don't have DOIs, so you would be working with this example. And you're kind of following the same pieces of information. So you put the author's last name, comma, first name, the year that it was posted, the title of the article, and then the title of the journal, and then you say when you retrieved it, and then from, and then you have your URL. Okay, so let's work on trying to format something from CQ Researcher. So I'm going to go to, remember that when you're working with our library databases, you go into our website, right, our Canvas page, and then it has, along the left-hand side here, our Canvas page has DACC Library This one doesn't, but I would click on library, it takes me to this page. I click on databases, and then I click on this link that says see all databases, and then I'm in this area. So I'm working with a CQ researcher, so I click on this one, and I've already done this before, so I don't want to go through that process. So let's say I've used this piece of information, so this article that says the future of the book is discussing the impact of online publishing and ebooks and how that's affecting printed books. So let's say I used information from this article that's by Heather Carradine, and this would be considered one of those periodicals. So it's an article that I found on the database, and it's in this CQ researcher site. So what I want to do, I'm going to bring my Word document here. Remember that your essay is in Times New Roman 12-point font size. And this is your references. This title is bolded according to the APA 7th edition. So my title will be the same size as the rest of my essay, the same font, and it's title references, no punctuation, nothing, it's just bolded, and then it's centered, and then for the next line, I can align it to the left, so I just press enter, and then I press this button up here above the paragraph, I align it to the left, so it's no longer centered, and then I will start formatting this entry. So I know that the person's name is Heather Carradine, future of the book. So I'm following this this piece of information because it's an article from an online periodical. And that this should not be bolded, so only my title should be bolded. Period, so I just need the person's initial of their first name. Let me see what date I have. And even though on here it just says the year, you include whatever piece of information you have, as specific as it is. So if I get a month and a day, I should include that on my reference page. So up here, I notice that it says March 13th, 2020. So I'm going to put that. I know it's from CQ Researcher, so I won't have to be jumping back and forth. So 2020. I'll change that again. And then parentheses, period, future of the book, period, and let's see, CQ researcher, let me see what piece of information I need. So I got that right, future of the book, CQ researcher. Let me go back to looking at this example for future of the book, security researcher. So this tells me that I need to make sure that I italicize the name of the journal that I'm working with. And here I'm just like looking to make sure that I'm doing this correctly. So it says title of periodical, italicized, volume, issue, if I get that, and then the DOI, if I have one, if there are no DOI, this, right? So I'm going to look right now to see if I have a DOI. information at the bottom. So I always scroll down to the bottom. So no, I don't think I have a DOI. And I noticed that the journal, the online journal needs to be in italics. And then I didn't have a DOI, but it did tell me to put the volume and the issue. So it tells me title of periodical, comma, volume, issue. I'm going to look at the example to make sure that I'm understanding how that should look. Page numbers, period. And then in this one too, your truth form. It's a volume issue that I'm looking at. Okay. I'll go to my word. So here I need a comma, volume. Volume 30, issue 11. Volume 30, issue 11. A DOI if I had one, but I don't have one, so I'm okay to put a period now. And a number. Now it's comma again, page numbers. If you notice, I didn't have page numbers on here, and I didn't see there's page numbers. So there are no page numbers. So what comes next if I don't have page numbers? The DOI or the website. So I'm going to have to follow this one, retrieved on what date, and then from. So can I put a period after the volume issue? I would say yes to the period because I don't have page numbers. The period. So retrieved from, retrieved on, retrieved and date and from, retrieved date, so I'm working on April, and then here, this, anything, if I'm taken to the next line, it has to be indented. I press the tab key, and it's the key next to the Q, the letter Q on your keyboard. So I press tab, it indents it for me. So I'm putting the date, which is 6/20, comma, from, and then the URL. And here it is, so usually I just do copy paste. So, these are tricky, these URLs, especially if you copy-paste them, and so it's up to you if you want to manually put it in, although sometimes it can get, whatever approach you take, it's going to be tedious. So, make sure that if you do it manually, like meaning you're typing everything out letter by letter, then that you do it correctly. Here, when I pressed the return the backspace button, I feel like it eliminated one of the symbols, and you need to be careful with that because then it is no longer correct. So if your reader were to click on this, it wouldn't take them to the correct site. So just make sure that it's correct, and yeah, that's so when I pressed the backspace button, it took out this hyphen that is necessary. So if you notice up here, I have a hyphen there. And so what I need to do is, and you need to format this because this is not clean. Or this is sloppy. It should be all the way over here up until like the end of the line, and then whatever doesn't fit should go to the third line, but sometimes that gets messy. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna kind of gauge it, and I think this might be a good place that I could, I'm pressing enter, so I'm putting my cursor here because I want all of this information to get back up to the second line. So right there I'm pressing enter, and that's why links are really difficult to work with. Okay, so how do I do this? So because I was trying to play around with it, it took me to the link online. So what I'll do is maybe I'll press enter here. Let's see what happens if I press tab. So if I press tab there, takes me, like keeps it all together. But if you notice on the example, I'll do references. Notice here, this example, how it goes all the way to the end, and then anything that doesn't fit is taken to the next line. And this is a short DOI, so it all fits in one line. So it's tricky. Like look at this one. Most of them have an all in one line. So let's see. Let me look at a student sample paper. So here, usually this is what I do. I go to the APA sample paper and I just make sure that my page looks similar to the one that the sample is offering. Okay, on this page, you should look at the student paper because the professional paper is going to look slightly different. Professional meaning that person is going to submit that paper for publication. So here, what I'll do, I'll scroll all the way down to the end of the sample paper and find the reference pages. Just saw it. So here's the reference page, starting on page 26. And it shows you, so just as I suspected, look at the sample reference. The URL goes all the way to the end of the line, and then anything that's left over goes to the next line. So notice how within each entry, anything that goes past that first line gets indented. So this one entry is 2 lines, this one entry is 3 lines, this other entry 3 lines. So I know these 2 lines are for this particular entry. So each entry starts off a line to the left, but any piece of information that needs to get shifted over to the next line gets indented. So just notice the format to that. A lot of times students do it opposite. They like indent the first line and then have anything that comes after the first line aligned to the left, and that's not correct. It's the opposite. Okay, so I'm going to do my best to try to format my URL to fit the way that they have it here. And if you're noticing the sample paper, most of the sources have DOIs, so that means that this person got most of the sources from a database that has the DOIs. But the first two that are listed on the references, they're not DOIs, so they're regular URLs. And I will go back to my paper and try to format it then. So I think the best thing for me to do is just do it manually. And because I have it listed there, that lets me copy it and type it out. And I know that this might seem tedious, but like I mentioned in class, give yourself time to do this. This, even though a lot of people leave it until the end, a lot of writers leave this, these steps until the end, and they want to kind of rush through it, it's tedious, and so you will need to make sure that you give yourself the amount of time that you need to correctly format it in the way that's necessary. And then I'm going to use this, and then what I'm going to do is just remove the hyperlink, so that way my writer would have to copy paste the hyperlink, so they won't be able to click on it, they would have to copy paste it, and that way it would be misleading. Okay, so that's one way to do this. This is kind of the long way, but this is the way that I recommend that you format your sources. You probably won't have too many sources, maybe 2-3, so it shouldn't take you too long. Going back to that student sample paper, make sure that you have the page number on your reference page, and then don't forget how your cover page should look like. So if you need a reminder of how to format your cover page, this APA sample paper on the Owlet Purdue site is helpful, and it points out all these boxes, point out the pieces of information that you should have. All you have to do is click on APA sample paper and make sure that you're looking at the student paper. And last thing that I'll do is I'll insert my page number, because and it's at the top of the page, right? So I'm up. So what I did, I went on my Word document, I went up here to insert. This toolbar comes out, I went to page numbers, brings these options up, and I clicked on top of page, and I want the third option. And since this one is not my page one, your page number will be the last page. This reference page will be the last page of your essay. You're either typing it on your essay, so you can control your page numbers in that way, or if you do like kind of copy-paste sort of thing, you could just copy this whatever you have on this document, paste it onto your actual essay. But in order to format your page numbers, you would go to Format Page Number, and then on this box, you could click here, and you can change what page you're starting from. So let's say my first four pages includes my cover page, my three pages of an essay, the body of my essay, so this is page 5, right? Page 1 is my cover page, 2, 3, and 4 on my essay, and my references is page 5. And last thing, if you only have one reference, then a hair at the top of your reference page will just say reference. If you have more than one, it will say references. I keep saying last thing and then I forget. Other ideas come to me. Don't forget that when you have multiple references, they should be alphabetized according to the letter that the entry starts with. So I'm going back to the sample paper. Notice how this reference page is alphabetized according with which the letter the entry start with. And it doesn't matter if the entry has an author or doesn't have an author. Notice how, like this entry, for example, doesn't have one specific author, it has a group. Or even if you have your entry start off with the title of a web page or a journal article, title of a journal article, you would use that letter to alphabetize your sources. So that's all I have for now, and hopefully this video will help you format essay number 3.